The radio button object is great for those times when you want to limit the user to just one of several possibilities. Just like the other switches, this switch only modifies the tag. It's then up to the PLC to do something about it. Look at how the radio button switch affects the tag. This radio button is connected to this tag. It's a little different than the other switches. The first button changes the tag to a 1. That's okay. The second button changes the tag to a 2. That's okay. But the third button changes it to a 4. The fourth button to an 8. The fifth button to a 16. See the pattern? Each button on the switch modifies a single bit in a 16-bit word. That means you're limited to a maximum radio button width of 16 buttons, one for each bit. Let's do an example and see how to set this up. Double-click or drag the radio button onto the screen. Just pick the number of buttons you want. We'll use 05 here. And specify the tag that the switch will modify. We'll use the conveyor tag in this example. See the How to Use Common Object Features video for all of these formatting options. We're not going to mess with that here. On this radio button object, you can set the on and the off text for each individual button. Just choose the button to modify right here. We'll put a 1 in for both the on and the off text, a 2 here, a 3 here, a 4 there, and finally a 5 here. In addition to a round versus rectangular style, we use the rectangular, you can also specify the orientation of the switch. The text automatically realigns. Again, you can test this button anytime you want by using the simulator. Select the button you want to test, and you can see what the end result's going to look like. Hit OK. Resize the button. Place it on the screen where you want it. And hit Simulate. Save the project. And up pops our simulator. Just as we saw earlier, these buttons are modifying individual bits in this conveyor tag. If I press 1, I get a 1. 5 gives me a 16. What about these function keys on the front bezel of the CMR Micro? Can we use those to control the radio buttons? Sure, let's take a look. Go back to our project, double-click on the object. Up here in the right-hand corner, you can select a function key for each button. So for button 1, we'll select function key 1. 2, we'll select function key 2. 3, we'll select function key 3. Now notice, function keys 1 and 2 are no longer available. You can only have one function key per button. Let's go ahead and finish this out. Assign 4 to 4. And finally, 5 to 5. Press OK. Simulate. Save the project. Now in addition to our touchscreen modifying both the buttons and the tag, our function keys do also. Well, that's it for this video. Be sure to check out all the other videos in this series. And as always, please send us any topics you would like to see covered, or any other comments for that matter. We appreciate the feedback.